Good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
Good evening.
My name is Jack Chin, and I have a nickname that was given by my first speech evaluators in Toastmaster 3 years ago. The Jacks of Hearts. That's the reason behind that I want to raise this up. But by the way, I just let everyone know my background. I was graduated in 2014 from UBDs and majored in economics. Currently, I'm working as a product specialist who sells ergonomic furniture. So that's my background, really. Quite plain. And my biggest strength and weakness is being forgetful. Strength and weakness, people say, why is it the same thing? Okay, let's talk about the disadvantage first. The disadvantage of being forgetful is most of the time you frustrate people because you tend to forget things that people call you to do and you're not doing it, especially my mom. Call me to do laundries, call me to cooking, I never do it. So my mom also gets frustrated. This is the disadvantage of being forgetful. The advantage of being forgetful is whatever bad memory that you want to forget, that you don't want to remind yourself again, you can easily forget about. And that, I'm not saying I'm doing very well, but not bad. Whatever happened to me 1 month ago, I most of it forget already. But what I want to share with everyone tonight is my progress of my fears. Let's talk back to 1 decade ago. 1 decade ago, 10 years. My biggest fears. My biggest fears is English language. Because as a Chinese guy who raised up in a Chinese family, my strength or what am I good at is only my Mandarin, my mother tongue. But other than my mother tongue, English language is horrible for me. Especially in high school. Grammatical rules is confusion for me. And because of this, during my high school, I have to suffer from it. What I suffered is I had to re-attempt my O-level examination for 6 times. 1 year, it's only have 2 examinations I have to suffer from. 6 times, meaning it's 3 years I have to suffer straight. How I go through it, I have to read, I have to try to speak to my friend. And every time the result come out, I have to reattempt again. I have to speak, I have to read, I have to reattempt again. 6 times, this is how hard I have to struggle my English. 3 years ago, when I finished up, when I finished my degree, and I saw the club Toastmaster, I took out my courage, and I just go to a club, because it's English medium. English speaking part. So it's the most nerve-wracking experience I ever had. Just going to a club, I don't know what will happen. It's like, okay, I just need to go in there and then listen to it again. Let's see what happens. But after the meeting, because of the people that tell me, from here you can actually learn your speaking skill, learn your communication skill, and learn your leadership skill. So I think, okay, I was just graduated. I haven't found a job yet during that time. But it's like, speaking is really essential in the society. If I'm not mastering in this, I think my life is just over with this. So I said, okay, I just have to take the step, took the challenge. And then I joined the club, be a member. Be as a role players and be the first speaker. Slowly by slowly, I become a Mr. Yes. What I mean by Mr. Yes? Meaning that every role that's assigned to me, I say yes, no problem. I practice, I want to go for it. Every role I practice and practice and practice, except for one role. Grammarian. Everything given to me, I say yes, except for grammarian. I said, grammarian, Jack, you want? No. Not grammarian. Because I always doubt myself. In my mind I always said, I'm not a good English common speaker. So how can I take grammarian role? I don't want to mislead all the members. This is my thought. And my mentor during that time, Steve, came to me and said, if you think your grammar, your English is weak, then you need to practice. Practice it makes you progress. practice it until you find that you're comfortable with the role. Until today, a lot of role players right now that specifically assign the grammarian role to me, I say yes, I'm okay with that. I just took up the challenge because I know that this is the way I can improve on myself. Even though I cannot improve now, but step by step. And as I mentioned, besides the English one, once you polish your English already, that's it. Because in the future, what I want to become is, as I mentioned, the Jack of Hearts. A lot of people don't know really what Jack of Hearts means. Jack of Hearts represents easygoing leaders that can understand and also give a supportive environment to the team members to grow. So what I want to be as a leader, not only in Toastmaster, but in my work field or in my everyday life, I want to just give people encouragement, understand everyone more, to give them the support. Ladies and gentlemen, a wise man once told me, progress does not make you perfect because there's a lot of things for us to improve on in our life. Practice will only make a person progress. Because through progress, you can slowly achieve it step by step to your objective or your goal. So whatever you feel that you can't do it, or whatever you feel that is very hard to achieve it, through practice, try with your practice every single time. Because one day, you will achieve what you want to. And with that, back to you.